Just about 66 million years ago, everything was normal. Then something is weird. Something was getting bigger and bigger. Thus, asteroid falls in South Atlantic Ocean. An explosion that could express divine power. The 186 billion years ago region of dinosaurs on Earth is stone with a size of 10 kilometers and enough power to destroy any civilization. It becomes the death of dinosaurs. Let's go back to February 15, 2013 at the 9:20 local time.
Eyes of the world today stunned by this image. This was debris from a meteor racing toward Earth, streaking across the sky there.
Residents of the city Chulyabinsk, Russia, witnessed something few humans ever have. An asteroid exploding in the atmosphere. Asteroid with a diameter of 20 meters enters the Earth. But maybe this was our luck, which is burned due to the Earth's atmosphere at a distance of 30 kilometers from the Earth. The explosion created a flash that was briefly brighter than the sun and released the same amount of energy as 500 kilotons of TNT, around 30 times more energy than the nuclear bomb detonated at Hiroshima. But 60 hours later, at an altitude of 27,700 meters above the ground, it could be a danger to the Earth. It is totally acceptable to worry about an asteroid crashing into the Earth, even though most asteroids are smashed before they enter the Earth's atmosphere. Just like an asteroid caused the extinction of dinosaurs, they can leave their orbits and hit the Earth. So, what happens if the bad scenarios happen? That is, an asteroid hit Earth. If an asteroid hitting the Earth, dust and smoke rising in the atmosphere prevents sunlight from reaching our world and causes the total temperature to drop. This event can lead to the death of many living things. If an asteroid the size of a 20 story building hits Earth, this blow can completely flatten a small country. But the place where the meteor hit is also very important, whether it's on water. If meteor were to hit the Earth and land in water, it would generate a significant underwater shock wave. The impact creates a large craters in water because most of the energy of the impact goes to vaporizing in the meteor and water. These craters is filled by inrushing water, which then meets in the middle and causes a central jet to push upwards, just as can be seen when dropping pebbles into a pond. Tsunami triggered by asteroid impact causes a disaster similar to the 2004 Asian tsunamis, once every 6,000 years on average, according to the first detailed analysis of their effects. Researchers have assumed that tsunamis would make an ocean impact more deadly than those on land. Generally speaking, getting hit by an asteroid is a bad day for life on Earth, even if it's a part of the natural cycle of living in the dynamic and evolving solar system. Marooning space, rocks flying around the interplanetary space with no regard for Earth's precious biosphere. If have our planet in their sights, they're going to hit us. But the question is how to save Earth from doomsday impact and what is the best option for us. Nuclear weapons are generally considered a move of last resort. They're also technically banned by the Outer Space Treaty of 1967. But most people assume if the alternative is planet-wide destruction, the treaty can be ignored. Simply exploding a bomb near the surface of the offending asteroid could be enough to alter its trajectory. This means rocket could deliver a nuclear payload without need for humans to go anywhere near the impactor. Large warheads can weigh up to a ton, but for all the weight, you get an explosion measured in millions of tons of TNT, enough to shift a sizable asteroid. The wonderful thing about space is that physics become a strange and idealized thing. If you imaginary tug a multi-million ton rock out of the way on Earth, it seems nearly impossible. But in space, friction ceases to exist. Bodies move about as dictated gravity. So, if you put something heavy near an asteroid, you can pull it off track. This method happens slowly, it would only change the asteroid course at a rate of millimeter or centimeter per second. So you need a lot of lead time. But should we happen to find a monster asteroid out there heading toward us with 100 years of lead time? But when we look at the phenomenon in future, we realize something is strange. Back to 2004, scientists predicted an asteroid named Apophis would have 2.7% chance of impacting Earth. And 5 years later, if it hit us, it would be more powerful than hundreds of nuclear bombs, and people were fairly terrified. Now, with more evidence, we know that at 13-2024, Apophis passed just 30,000 kilometers above the Earth, and there is no chance to hit us. But there are a lot of Apophis in our space with different percent of chance to hit us. So, are we actually safe?